up, I go to bed thinking about what can I do next? What can I create next that's gonna knock people's socks off?
Christine, you wanna dig into the creme brulee?
The creme brulee cupcake.
This one you may need a fork for.
Oh, should I,
it's got a lot of beautiful custard inside. Crack that. Yes. What is that to its name? It is. See the reaction?
So good.
Exactly.
It's so good. It's like heaven. Mm-hmm. I hope they have this in heaven.
But when I die and go there, I'll bring this for you, okay? I'll be waiting for you.
Yeah.
But you get the lightness of the cake. The custard is delicious. Vanilla custard. And then as you're eating it, you get the crunch of the sugar on top. It is truly delicious.
Yeah.
Divine.
It is.
Divine. This is why this is my favorite cupcake. Doesn't need no frosting. And you see why.
Yeah. At the end of like a super long day, because you're, you know, out busy pursuing your passion.
Yes.
You need one of these creme brulee cupcakes.
And a glass of champs.
Yeah.
Or wine.
Delicious. Yeah, this would be good with both kinds of wine, actually.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Indeed. With like Cabernet. Mm.
Yeah. Don't tempt me. We have that in the fridge outside.
Can't drive home, Sean. You're stuck with me.
Yeah, guest room. I'll tell your husband. Just do it no matter what. Make it happen.
Yeah. Be a diva.
A dessert diva.
What? We are with Tracie Young right now, and she is also known as the dessert diva.
Yes, yes.
And you were telling me 2 years ago, you just decided to do this.
Yes.
I mean, tell me the story.
My last job, I was working at JP Morgan Chase. I was a senior admin assistant, and the job after about 6-7 months became really monotonous, and I just didn't want to do it anymore. And I noticed I was just getting more and more into creating desserts, and I would bring stuff to the office. I'd bring cake pops, and you know, if there was ever a function that we had. So I was always bringing stuff, and I loved it. And I was like, I have to do this. And luckily for me, my husband was in a position, you know, to be able to kind of carry the load while I kind of dived into this. And lo and behold, like, it literally took off within 6 or 7 months. It took off. And I had all my stuff on Instagram, and then I had a couple celebrities calling to do stuff. And then once that happened, they got the word out, and then that's really when it, you know, it exploded for me. So yes.
Desserts are your passion.
They are definitely my passion. It's something, you know, this past weekend I had like 6 orders to knock out for different clients. And even though I was tired, I can be on my feet for 13 hours, 14 hours, and I haven't eaten or haven't done anything because I'm so immersed in it. And I love it. I get up and I'm like, what can I create? And I love when my clients send me pictures, I want you to create this. So it's like, how can I get really creative and just knock it out of the park for them? And every time, like, cake after cake, cupcake after cupcake, anything, like, it, they love it. And it just keeps me motivated. But I wake up, I go to bed thinking about what can I do next? What can I create next that's gonna knock people's socks off?
That's amazing.
Yes.
So wait, time out. Do you do it all right here?
I
in
do.
This kitchen?
Yes. I have 2 KitchenAid mixers back there that I use. Those are my friends. My girlfriends. I love them. They don't let me down. The best investment ever. Thank you, husband. So, yes, I do it all right here. One oven. I have a refrigerator outside that kind of hold everything once I'm done making it. And I somehow get it done. But I don't know.
That is amazing. So I mean, the pictures of the stuff that you create are literally out of this world. It looks too good to eat. I like the cake size. They saw you post like a pink cake this morning.
Yes.
Is that what we're going to be showing?
No,
how did you do that?
That cake was for a client. And that is the cake that you did see was a diamond and roses cake. So all the whole center was covered in rhinestones. The bottom covered in beautiful pink roses, and then the top had a beautiful rhinestone topper, and then kind of stones cascading down the front of it, so it just all kind of meshes together. And that's actually one of my bigger sellers. The girls
ladies love it. It's a beautiful show-stopping cake. So definitely glamorous.
It is super beautiful. So so you said you cooked for celebrities.
Yes.
Chris Brown.
Yes, Chris Brown. I did his daughter Royalty's Frozen theme birthday. I've done Viola Davis when she had her birthday last year. Who else? Tamar Braxton, I've done. Erica Mena, a lot of reality stars I've done, and they've all been great clients, and you know they come back time after time to keep ordering. So I feel very blessed about that. So thank goodness for them.
That's amazing. Yes. And just literally 2 years ago, you were doing something.
I was pushing papers in an office, literally, and having someone tell me what to do and where to file this and order supplies for the office or set up a conference room for a meeting. So it was, my job was, you know, I was just someone telling me what to do all the time. And it's just like, I couldn't do it. And I just felt like I was caged a little bit, because now I can just be creative and I'm on my own schedule, and you know, it allows me the freedom to really do what I love. So I'm happy.
I am so impressed by you.
Thank you.
You truly are a badass modern female.
Thank you. I could be badass. Yes.
Yes. This is awesome.
Thank you.
Where did you learn to do this?
I want to say early on, when I was about 13, 14, my mom had me in the kitchen. She said, if you want to land a husband, honey, you need to get in this kitchen and learn how to cook. So on top of the desserts that she would make, it was a lot of Southern food. So, you know, the greens, the fried chicken, sweet potato pie, butter cake with caramel sauce. And my mom never used anything from the box. It was always scratch. And she said, you know, people can tell when you use real butter, real vanilla, real everything. So it may cost you a little more, you know, but this is why you have people coming back to you, because they can taste the real ingredients that you put into it. So yeah, my mom had me in the kitchen very early, and then it just kind of carried on. I've had jobs, I served in the military. I wasn't able to really do what I wanted to do up until, you know, like I said, recently. So this is a result of being able to put out everything that's in my mind. I love to be really creative, and this is the outcome. What you see here.
These all look so beautiful, and I can't wait to eat them, but I still have more questions.
Of course. Ask away.
So, I mean, when you took that big chance, when you walked into your boss's office and you were like, sayonara, mm-hmm. I want to cook desserts.
Yes.
What were you thinking?
Oh, my God. What am I going to do? It's one thing, you know, to be able to have that support like I get from my husband, and like I said, to be able to, you know, carry the load for the family. But still, there's so much competition out there, you know, and that was one question that I asked myself over and over again. What is going to make me different from everyone else? There is sprinkles. There is so many different cupcake businesses that are thriving. They're huge. And I said, I have to do something completely different. So, you know, these strawberry gems, the cupcakes with the donuts on them. I've done, you know, shrimp and grits, chicken and waffles. I've done bacon and eggs with sunny side up eggs on it. And people respond very well to that. But that was the biggest thing. How do I make myself different? And this is what I came up with.
Beautiful. Next is sweet potato and greens. Yeah. Fried chicken.
Yeah. Right.
Fried chicken on top of one of those.
Right.
Well, you do that with the chicken and waffles.
I did that with the chicken and waffles. Yes. And that was a huge hit. People loved it, and they still order it to this day. I think I introduced that probably a year and a half ago, and people still order the chicken and waffles. They want it for the girls have a brunch or something. Oh, let's bring 2 dozen chicken and waffles, and they're all eaten. They eat them all, so they're delicious.
I believe you.
Yes. Believe it.
I believe it. I'm curious though, it's gone great. Mm-hmm. Everything's gone really great, but there are times where you were like, holy crap, this is a really big step outside my comfort zone. what if? Like, what kept you moving when you made that leap?
What kept me moving, and I think it was, I had a lot of support from our friends and family first and foremost when I started. So they actually started, we'll pay for your desserts. We don't want them for free. So they really supported the business, my business. And it reaffirmed, it's like, okay, I'm good enough. And I've had, my friends are very honest. They'll tell me if something doesn't taste good or anything like that. But there were a lot of times where I did doubt myself and said, what am I doing? What am I doing? If I would, I jumped into cakes, which I had really no
familiarity
I
got with. Girl.
Yes. I wasn't too familiar with cakes, using fondant and, tiered cakes. And I jumped into that, and I had a couple disasters, and, I remember, crying with my husband. I said, babe, like, I don't think I'm cut out for this. Like, I really wanted to give up because I don't like to fail. But, he would keep me motivated. He said, you know what, babe, you messed up. It's a learning experience. What went wrong? And I could say, I might have used a different type of fondant. He goes, don't do that. Use the same fondant every single time. You know it's dependable. Don't, just learn from your mistakes. Do repeat those mistakes. And that's what's gotten me through from actually quitting. My husband's been a very big help, to keep me going and keep me motivated.
Love him.
He's blushing.
Yes.
Oh, honey.
That's wonderful. And I think that you're really lucky to have that support. I think a lot of women are lucky when they have people who are supporting them in their lives.
Definitely.
Especially when they take that leap to, step outside their comfort zone, pursue their passion because they feel empty. Like, mm-hmm. they feel like they need something more.
Right.
To me, being a BAMF is just that, mm-hmm. is taking that step outside your comfort zone to follow your passion no matter what. Mm-hmm. What does being a BAMF mean to you?
Being bold, not being afraid of failure, embracing who you really are, embracing that passion, not sweeping it to the side for anything. And when you do fail, you're able to learn from those failures and still keep going. And just keep growing, keep expanding, keep gaining knowledge. That is so important. You have to just go out there and do it. That's the one thing I never wanted in my life, was to be like, what if I didn't go for this? And you just, watch other people achieve their goals and their dreams, and you're sitting back because you're too scared to do it. And that's one thing I never want for myself. So being fearless is just huge for me. Just go do it. Just do it no matter what. Make it happen.
Yeah. Be a diva.
A dessert diva.
What?
Perfect. Well, let's dig in because I can't even handle it anymore. Like, it smells so good. And you guys don't even know.
You can't even smell it.
I can smell it. So this first one over here is what?
This is shrimp and grits. Now, this is what I mean by stepping outside of the box and not doing a traditional cupcake. We all seen lemon, chocolate, vanilla. Shrimp and grits is where it's at. It's actually a very delicious cupcake. It's very mild and light in flavor. So you have a vanilla cupcake with a vanilla buttercream. Grits sweetened a little bit with butter and sugar. And I have a chili glaze, sweet piece of shrimp on the top, which is delicious.
My eyes are like, I want it.
Yes, this is one of the more exotic cupcakes, but if you're adventurous, you'll like this one.
This shrimp looks so good. I can't believe you just made that here.
Yeah, right?
It's amazing. You're amazing.
Yes.
Before you move on, I just want to take a picture. I feel like I
Please
need to get a
do.
Picture of this shrimpy. This is amazing. Instagram. Sean, you are so lucky. Yeah. Do you know? You must know.
I do, but it's hard to lose weight.
Who needs to lose weight these days? Just embrace yourself.
Oh,
Love yourself, no matter what.
Embrace all of it.
Yes.
Okay, so that's it, the shrimp and grits.
Okay, so we have a chocolate cupcake, chocolate fudge cupcake with a chocolate icing, and it is covered in a peanut butter glaze. So who doesn't love peanut butter and chocolate? That is a classic flavor combination, and this is just divine.
Yeah.
Divine. She's gonna keel over. She'll love it. Next. Next, we have, this is actually one of my personal favorites. This is something, you know, you want to have in the evening time. You want to get a glass of wine and eat this. This is a creme brulee cupcake. We have the champagne. Have a sip.
Yeah.
We have the creme brulee cupcake, and it is literally a delicious, very light vanilla cupcake. It is filled with a homemade filling. Custard inside, delicious. And then, as you can see, the top is very shiny. You hear that tap, tap.
I heard it.
And you have, so I went and brulee the sugar on top, so it's nice, caramelized, and it's gonna give off the crunch when you go ahead and, you know, cut into that. It's delicious. This is actually one of my favorites.
There's no frosting on this.
This
is just the creme brulee.
This is just the brulee, and you do not need frosting because you don't wanna take away from everything that's going on inside this cupcake. The custard is enough to seal the deal for you. Cinnamon toast cupcakes. This is actually a very good cupcake. A lot of vanilla going on with butter and cinnamon mixture together with a little bit of vanilla in there. I bake all that together and it just comes together. It's so delicious. This has a homemade vanilla buttercream, which tastes like ice cream, on top of this, and garnish with a cinnamon stick. These are very popular with my clients. These are my strawberry diamond gem shots. They are designed to look like diamonds. So when you pick them up and you kind of move your hand around, they glisten and shine. They are gorgeous. And these are actually filled with strawberry pomegranate vodka. You can have any type of liquor that you want in your shots, with the exception of champagne, due to the bubbles, yes. Yeah. But I've had people have whiskey, tequila, whatever your flavor is, you can put it in here.
I think strawberry pomegranate vodka sounds good.
Yes, it is delicious. And up front with the donuts on top is a vanilla cupcake with a coffee buttercream frosting, and top with a delicious old-fashioned donut dipped in chocolate and sprinkles. Very delicious. So if you like a coffee, you're a coffee person, you love to run a Starbucks every day, this is your cupcake. It'll give you a little bit of kick from the coffee, but everything marries well together. Is delicious.
Oh, my Lord.
Yes.
I could pass out.
Yeah. Too much sugar for you. But they're all delicious. So Christine here will get to taste everything.
Don't be jealous.
And have it. Don't be jealous. You can always order.
So
call me.
How much do these cost?
These type of cupcakes are considered custom, with the exception of the chocolate and peanut butter. That is standard. This is what it would look like. I don't skimp on the garnish, anything like that. Things can be a little over the top, but there are standard cupcakes, and they start at 45 per dozen. For something like shrimp and grits, you're gonna pay like $7 per cupcake, but it is a delicious cupcake.
I mean, I'm gonna need a $7 cupcake.
Yes, you're gonna need a $7 cupcake. The creme brulee would be another $7 cupcake. The cinnamon toast is actually a standard cupcake. So as you see, it is what you would get with a standard cupcake. The coffee and donuts cupcake would be another example of a custom. So this is more of a $6 range cupcake for you. So yeah, and these strawberry gems are 36 per dozen without the shots, and they are 45 per dozen with shots of liquor in them.
Yeah. So how do you deliver? Like, how
I do deliver.
Okay, so you are the one who like shows up.
I will show up.
She's gonna have a whole bunch of employees.
Yes, I will. I show up to your home or place of business, and I will deliver these personally to you. They are freshly made. I try to make them fresh either the evening before or the day of, depending on what time you need your delivery or you want to. You can also pick up if you like. But yeah, they're usually made within a day. They're not sitting there for days behind a cabinet, you know, that they've been sitting there forever. These are made very, very fresh, so you're not going to get anything that's super old. Be all fresh for you.
Girl, you need to get on the chew.
Right?
Good stuff.
Yeah. Please chew. Love to come.
Carla and you together, right. She's Southern too.
Yes. So then, yeah. Exactly. I think Carla would love this. Carla,
she would lose it.
Yes.
She loves the comfort food. I'm obsessed with her.
Exactly.
So cheers to you.
Cheers.
And thank to you. Your fabulous desserts.
Thank you very much.
I'm excited. And thirsty. Sean, I am so jealous of you.
Tracie, like, almost took over for a while. Like, you got really comfortable there. I was worried because you get nervous in front of people, but you were good.
I do get nervous.
You were really good.
Thank you.
No, you were great.
Yeah.
Awesome.
You were very comfortable.
Thank you.
Yeah, you just...
Well, she makes me comfortable, too, so it's
you guys...
Nice.
Yeah, well, that's her job, right? The icebreaker is what makes you comfortable.
Right.
We did
well, you guys might as well try a strawberry shot.
Oh, we're going to try everything.
We're going to try everything.
I feel like I need to, like, Snapchat this. Or something.
I don't know how to Snapchat to save my life. I probably should learn Snapchat.
You Instagram, right? Insta Story.
Oh, they have that too.
Insta Story.
My phone, please, babe.
Well, I'll just do some social media posting.
Yeah,
before we dig in. Yeah.
You may want to edit that Chris Brown thing. After today, there may be a lot of bad pub.
No. His name is a keyword.
Oh.
His name is a keyword. So hashtag Chris Brown desserts. Boom. More people are interested.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. There is no bad press, remember?
Okay. Yeah, that's true.
So wait, this is this little thing here, right? The story?
Yeah, so no. You go like this.
Okay.
Uh-oh, Tracie. So you just pulled that. Here, I'll do one first, and then you can swatch. So this is shrimp and grits.
Shrimp and grits. Chocolate peanut butter.
No, why isn't it going? Just my battery might be full. Or my, because, you know, I have so much stuff on here.
Oh.
So you can do it, because mine isn't working, but... Okay, just hold it down. Yes, that's it. Look at all those babies. That's amazing. And the dessert diva made them. Now I get to eat them. So awesome. You can hear it. I was just giving you some dialogue.
Okay.
That's amazing. And the dessert diva made
them. Oh, we got cut off there.
So you can cancel it, and we could do another one, but that's how it works. Like, you can say anything you want, tell people what this is, tell people what's happening.
Okay, there we go. We got some shrimp grits, chocolate and peanut butter, creme brulee, coffee and donuts, strawberry gems, and cinnamon toast cupcakes.
Oh, yeah.
Holla. Okay.
Holla.
That's good. Awesome.
I don't even know.
Fingers. The struggle. Okay, so what do you want to film as far as tasting?
Okay, whatever. No. All of them.
It's all of them. Good boy, Oscar. Thank you. You're so quiet and patient.
I think he's tired.
I need a nap. My life is so hard.
Oh, it is.
You know, stop being a little dog.
Those little puppies. Okay. Okay, let me take a picture with you.
Okay.
Let's hold one. Which one should we do? I want this one. I'm really curious.
Hold your
shrimp
and grits.
Yeah.
I will hold my cinnamon toast.
Ready? 1, 2, 3. Let me get your face more. 1, 2, 3. Perfect.
Awesome.
Oh, decline, friend. All right, let's try shrimp and grits.
All right, we're going to try shrimp and
grits.
This one used to go on the plate.
Oh, really?
Okay. Yeah, there's just a bunch of different layers.
Oh, yeah?
To this. So unless you're feeling adventurous, you can just tip the shrimp over on its side and take a big bite. All whatever you want to do.
Oh, I'll do it. That's what I'm going to do.
You don't have to be cute.
I'm not.
We can be messy.
Okay.
Yes, goodness.
Oh my gosh, it tastes so good. Just the marinade or whatever.
Yes.
What's your favorite one, Sean?
Probably, it might be this one. What is this one called?
Shrimp vinaigrette.
The cinnamon toast.
The cinnamon toast.
It's really good. Mm-hmm. She did cinnamon toast crunch with the cereal one time.
Very good.
Well,
cornbread.
Ice cream cupcakes are my favorite.
Then grits.
Cornbread.
Cornbread. Buttercream. Grits. The sweet chili. Shrimp on top. Perfect blend of sweet and savory. It is delicious.
Oh my gosh, you need a booth somewhere. It's so good. Mm. Oh man.
That's delicious.
That shrimp is so good, Tracie.
Thank you.
It's so healthy too, because grits.
And the corn in the cornbread.
And the shrimp is healthy.
Shrimp is very healthy for you.
Oh my god. I like want to eat all of this.
We're going
one.
To town.
Have any other room?
Okay.
What other one should I try?
I think you guys should do the strawberries next.
Yeah.
Just have a little.
You've done one cupcake, you one strawberry.
Wash it down.
Okay. I really plan to eat the rest of that. But cheers again.
Cheers.
God, Tracie. I like can't believe you came up with this stuff.
Yes, I think we do. Christine's happy land right now.
I am. I am literally, if you were trying to seduce me at work.
Cut! Okay. Got her.
Yeah.
That is a surpriser. So.
Okay. I feel like I definitely need to take a picture of this. This looks amazing.
I'm going to be adding, putting my crumbs back on the plate. Sorry.
Whoa.
Yeah. The bling is in full effect here. So, there's no wrong way.
There's no wrong way to
eat
these.
Is that
recording? I've had.
Oh, I can tell by the red flashback here. Okay.
There's no wrong way to eat these strawberry gems. These can be made in any color that you want. I have any color in the rainbow for you, so whatever floats your boat. But what you can do, I've had clients take the shot out and take the shot first, or what I prefer to do is bite into it and squeeze at the same time.
Bite and squeeze.
Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Oh my word. This is fun.
Yes, it's a very fun interactive dessert to have. Delicious.
Mm-hmm.
Yes, baby showers. I've had them at baby showers, weddings, birthdays, especially bar mitzvahs, anything.
Oh my lord. That's
they work
so
for
good.
Anything.
Weddings? Did you say weddings?
Weddings.
Birthdays?
Birthdays, bar mitzvahs, all of it.
Anniversaries?
Anniversaries. I've had one of those, yes.
Valentine's Day?
Yes, and again, they don't have to be glitter either. If you just want a regular dip strawberry and chocolate with no decor on it, I can do that too. But this seems to be the most popular way to go with the bling. People
I'm
love it.
Eating all of it.
Oh, mm-hmm.
It's not here anymore.
Eat it all. It's okay. Yeah. I don't want any leftovers in my house.
Okay. I can take care of that.
Okay.
Oh my gosh, that's amazing. That's such a brilliant idea. I don't know one other person who's done that. Maybe I don't know, but like, are other people doing that?
There's people now that are doing it.
They copied you?
But yeah.
Posers.
Yes.
Oh,
I gave her one.
Okay. This is a mess.
Give her a bib, dude.
Please. Wow.
So, what I want to do now is I'm going to at least clean this off, clean the plate off. Dump this, excuse me. It's not good. Dump yours.
I need to delete something so I can, like. Oh, I didn't eat that.
Well, oh, there's an extra in there.
There's an extra one for
it. But I made three. She was like, wait, don't do that. Don't throw that away. A whole another one for you.
I'm hot.
Don't cry, Christine. Don't cry.
I'll try not to.
Okay.
Hold on, let me delete something.
Okay.
I have like all
job.
These pictures of my cats on my phone. You take up all of my
You're a cat lady?
Yes. My cats are so cute, Tracie. Do you like cats?
I'm allergic.
Oh.
Sorry. Too bad.
Do I have like glitter on my mouth?
You do. On your lips, you do. It never fails. You'll have glitter on your lips, people.
When she's doing those kind of orders, I'll walk around and I'll go to my friend's house or something and I don't notice there's glitter just on
like
my face.
Everywhere.
Glitter gets everywhere.
Looks like you came from the strip club. It's okay, babe.
My dad this is my dad. Sorry, side note.
Aww.
I got him the shirt for his birthday. It says Life Behind Bars.
Oh, he's a biker? I was like,
what? He also used to be a correction officer.
Oh,
so
my dad did too.
Like,
yeah.
Double funny. okay, next one. I feel like we need to do creme brulee, right?
Yes. I've been dying to get to that one. Creme brulee is the next one we're going to try.
Thank you.
Delicious. Alrighty. Like the crunch.
Should I crack it?
Yes. You can crack it. If you look inside. Beautiful custard inside. It is truly a creme brulee cupcake. It is delicious.
Hang out. I'm going to get a tight shot of that. You hold that.
Okay. Oh, goodness. Someone help.